Hello there students, welcome back to this video series. This is Dhruvi Bhatt talking today about, I think you are very much aware, we would be talking about etiquettes when you are on a foreign trip. This is your instructor Dhruvi Bhatt and we are dealing with different etiquettes which you need to follow. Okay, students, going on a vacation along with a stamp of this vacation being an official trip is everyone's dream. Okay, so is mine, so is yours. Here, many companies send their employees to foreign trips for different reasons. You can be one of them, but while you are on this trip, you must follow some of the etiquettes. First and foremost, are leisure trip and business trips one and the same? That is entirely a myth, students. Here you are going on a business trip, which means whether it is your own business or someone else's business, this trip must be profitable instead of being a lossy affair. Okay, right? For example, you must be gaining higher amount of money by doing business there instead of spending more amount of money there. So a leisure trip and a business trip are entirely different. Leisure trips do not have any etiquettes and I do not want to teach you any if there are, but business trips do have these etiquettes and you must follow these etiquettes to come out with flying colors and to successfully complete your trip for your organization. Okay, students, before going into details about what to do before the trip, during the trip and after the trip, I'll give you just some general guidelines with regards to this foreign trip. What are the general guidelines? What are the general scenarios which you need to understand and which you need to follow? First and foremost, do not, you are going there as a representative of your organization. Do not in any way let your organization down. Make sure that you hold up to the expectations of the organization and you always make sure that you do not let your organization down while you are there by your actions or by your words or by any other means. Okay. Secondly, students, make sure that you make only those commitments which are in your level of authority, because once you have made a commitment which is outside your authority, your organization is liable to fulfill that commitment which can go against you in many manners. So make sure that you do only those promises which you can fulfill. Okay. Thirdly, students, make sure, yes, it is obvious that you would be very much astonished by wonderful roads there and amazing monuments there or the great infrastructure there or the great laws and practices there being followed. But it does not mean that you criticize Indian roads or Indian people. Do not in any way badmouth your country while you are on a business trip outside your country. Respect your country, respect your organization. One more etiquette which you must follow is that keep up your religious and personal identity. It is okay to keep up your religious and personal identity, but do not let that come in between the business deals or within the business meetings. You can keep, it doesn't mean that you cannot keep your religious identity if you are wearing some rings of some gods or maybe some planets. You can have those ring on. If you have some particular habits, it is okay to follow those habits. It is okay to follow your religious practices. Everything is okay until and unless it doesn't come in between your business. Okay. Moving onwards, our fifth point says that you must find out appropriate restaurants on internet. If you have special choices, that if you are a vegetarian or if you have special choices in food, then make sure that you get to know about good restaurants beforehand so that it would not create chaos. Even if you are being invited and you are staying at the place which is arranged by your company or the organization, inform your organization beforehand your food and habitual requirements. This will make things easier for you as well as for the organization. Okay, one more thing which you must take care of is modes of transport. Students, there no, there it would not be an option that okay, I'll take a cab and go away. It would be very costly to run on foreign lands in cab. Okay, to go around from one place to another in a private cab is very costly there, and because you are going there for such less amount of time, it would be much difficult to spend that amount of money. That is why if you will ask someone, then they would just tell you the directions to a particular place. They will not tell you that which bus goes to that particular place, or which train goes, or which tram goes to that particular place. That is why you need to do your research well, you need to do your homework well, make sure that you get to know all the public transports, or you can take a ride from someone. Yes, outside India it is known as taking a ride, and you do not take a lift there. That is a bad word, do not use it. Okay, so now we would try to understand that what things you should take care, or what things you should keep in mind before you leave for your trip. First and foremost, make sure students that you know your mission. You must be knowing that why you are going there. Okay, for what reason this trip is planned. There can be many reasons. One of them can be to install some project at the customer's location. Secondly, this can be a knowledge building trip where you might be going there to attend a seminar which is given by some foreign counterpart of the company. Okay, thirdly, this can be just a due diligence kind of trip where you are just scoping around for opportunities. Okay, there can be many reasons for which this trip is established. You must be knowing the answers to many questions, like if this is a group trip, then who is assigned what work, and for what reason this trip is conducted. Secondly, you must be knowing that what are the expectations of the organization from this trip. Okay, these are some of the stated objectives. You must fulfill the unstated objectives too. The first unstated objective is building a good rapport. You are going there, and obviously you would be meeting new people who are related to your business, who are related to your organization. You might be having a long-term relation with them for a huge amount of time. That is why you make sure that you establish a good rapport, establish a good first impression and a good last impression when you leave, so that you can maintain a long-term relation with that people and a long-term business with those people. Secondly, make sure that you make good networks. You have gone there, do not waste your trip. Okay, make good networks, keep on networking with people, talk with different people, gain knowledge about that country, gain knowledge about business practices there. Do all such things to make this trip successful. So firstly, you must be knowing about your mission, the hidden missions as well as the original missions. Okay. Secondly, students, make sure that you are well prepared before you leave for the trip. Okay, whatever documents you need, have their soft copy as well as their hard copy. Do not rely upon a single copy, have multiple copies. Place the different locations in your bag. Keep all your documents handy, keep all your documents along with you. Okay, even back on your base home, keep your computer, keep your office computer very, very well organized, so that you have one scapegoat there, one person there with whom you can constantly communicate, and if you are missing some documents, that could be mailed to you immediately. So have at least one point of contact there. Make sure that you have all your contacts written down somewhere. You cannot give an excuse that okay, I had that contact in my phone and my phone is switched off, I'm not getting the charger, etc. Do not give such lame excuses. That is very bad. That looks very bad on our end. So you can use our age-old type of diaries or our books to write down all the contacts, all the emergency contacts. You must be having one emergency contact whom you can communicate with at any point of time to get any document or to get help when you are there in the foreign country. Make sure that you have proper winter clothes. Make sure that you have packed for different clothes and different items which you would be needing during your stay there. If you are some if you are on some medicines, then make sure that you have proper prescriptions. You have complete course of medicines packed with you for the entire duration of the trip, because in the foreign country it would be very difficult to get new prescriptions and to get the same content of the medicines in some other country. Okay, make sure that you get some knowledge of the country you are visiting. You make sure that you are knowing all the different things. If you are a part of a team, then make sure that you have all those documents which are there in your agenda, and others too have collected their documents. Do not rely upon one person to collect everything. Divide work and collect whatever is in your agenda or whatever is in your scope. Okay. Lastly, make sure that you have everything prepared for you for all the adversities, like if your luggage is lost, like if your passport is lost, like if you catch cold or if you have some medical problems there. Have insurances, have everything prepared before you go for the business trip. Okay. What are the things that you need to do during the trip? Okay. We discussed about what before going for a trip, but here we will discuss about what during the trip. First and foremost, students, make sure that you are aware of all the local laws and practices before going to any foreign country, because you are going there. In some countries laws are very strict. In some countries even jaywalking is considered to be illegal. Make sure that you are aware of laws and practices of that particular country before going there, because a lawsuit would be very costly in any country except India. Even in India it is very costly. A lawsuit in a foreign country to a foreigner is very, very costly, trust me. So beware of all the laws and practices, do your homework well, study all the laws before going there, and you are good to go. Follow these laws and practices during the trip. Okay. Secondly, respect privacy. While in your trip, we have an entire chapter, we have an entire video dedicated to respecting privacy. This is a very important topic with respect to etiquettes. But when you are in the foreign country, this is a very important aspect. Respect privacy of others and make sure that others too respect your privacy. No one should invade your privacy during your free time. And make sure you do the same. If someone doesn't want to leak information, or if someone doesn't want to share information about the foreign organization, do not poke them to do so. Respect each person's privacy. Do not ask questions which are outside your leak or outside your business agenda. Okay. Thirdly, while during your trip, try to interface with your co-workers or with your team very frequently. Okay, you can go out for different activities together. You can go out for a little dinner, a business dinner, or you can sit down for a business meeting or a group discussions there, and you can talk with them, because you are in a foreign country and you want to know maximum about how business is going on there. You want to take home good amount of knowledge from here. That is why interface properly, liaison with all the group members, make sure you communicate properly, come out as a very outsmart and very extraordinary, very extrovert personality to each one of the team members, and make sure you talk with them nicely. Okay, one more thing which you need to take care of is do not forget to network nicely. Okay, build your network nicely, build your network well, to make sure that if you come out here again, there are people standing with you steadfast. Okay, there are people waiting for you. There are people with whom you can redo business. Okay, so make sure that you do your networking well, you gel with people well, and establish networks well. Okay, one more thing. Make sure that whenever you are giving presentations on foreign land in front of the associates who are your foreign counterparts, you be very well prepared with the presentation, with your body language. We have already understood in the presentation strategies that what all things you should take care of. Make sure that you do proper planning, proper organizing of content, and deliver the presentation so nicely that they are impressed by your presentation and they feel obliged to do business with you. Okay, so give your presentations very nicely. Even if you are a part of a team there, make sure that all the team members work their part very nicely in the presentation or a meeting. Okay. One more thing you need to take care of is that be in constant touch with your boss. I like the picture. Be in constant touch with your boss back here in India. Constantly send him emails. Make sure that you have a particular time dedicated to talk to him and tell him all the ongoings of the day. Give a more detailed report in an email and do so very frequently. You can also send 2 to 3 mails daily. Okay. Make sure that your boss in India is constantly kept in touch and he knows about everything continuously. Secondly, make sure that if you give out any statements or pass out any or complete any business deals or pass out any business deals, you keep your boss informed and only with his permissions and only within his knowledge you do so. That would be beneficial to both you and your boss. Okay. One more thing. It is okay to talk within yourselves in your native language. It is okay. If you are a group of people who have gone to a business trip together, then you can talk within yourselves in your native language. It is okay sometimes because you would be feeling very nostalgic or very homesick. And that is why you would be missing your home language or your native language. It is okay to talk within yourself in native language, but make sure that you do not speak something very bad about the workings there or about the organization there or about different people there, because you would be knowing that even walls have ears, and who knows, there would be some people there knowing your native language too. So make sure that you do not badmouth about anything or anyone while you are talking in your native language. Many a times your expressions too would give away if you are talking something which is not very appropriate. So make sure that you talk appropriately, even if you do so within yourselves in your native language. That is okay. It is not a very big a deal. Okay. This is a business trip and not a junket. What is meant by a junket? A junket means a leisure full spender trip. Okay. Here you have not gone to a leisure Europe trip. So make sure that you do not spend huge lot of money. Do not spend huge lot of money. Make sure that you try to balance everything out. Use this whosoever money it is, your money or your organization's money. Do not turn this trip into a junket where you are just sightseeing or just wandering about. Even if you have to go sightseeing, do so on weekends. Even if you are going to visit your family there who is living in foreign country, then you can do so on weekends when you are not working. Secondly, even if you want to go sightseeing, do so with your own money and spend less amount of time in all these activities compared to business activities. Even if you are out for a weekend, make sure that someone in the organization is having your number and can reach you while you are out sightseeing. So do not convert this to a junket or leisure trip. Let it be a business trip because it is a business trip. Okay. The same thing which I told you, be very frugal in spending money, whosoever money it is, spend wisely. In different countries, there would be different rules and different expenses which you would not be already knowing about. Okay. Many things which are free in India might not be free somewhere else. Like for example, internet or laundry. All these things might be chargeable and it would be a huge cost to you if you use them like you are using in India. So make sure that before you use anything, you know the costs associated with it. Secondly, even there are rules with respect to tipping someone. Like for example, in USA, the tip money is already included in the restaurant bills, while in Singapore, it is compulsory to give a tip of at least 15% of the restaurant bill. So be aware of all these things before you spend money. Be aware of the expenses which you need to bear. Use public transport if the public transports are good in that particular country. Be aware of the public transport. Do not spend like there is no tomorrow, because there is a tomorrow. And when you come back, do not forget to submit that expense report, because you would have spent a lot. Okay. So students, what are the things that you need to do after the trip? One of the thing I already told you. Let us see some others that what things you need to take care of after the trip. First and foremost, make sure that you send your counterpart a thank you email. Okay, send him or her a thank you email stating that you enjoyed your trip, stating that they very nicely treated you and you are looking forward to doing business with them in future too. Secondly, sit down with your boss and talk with him about all the details and all everything which you talked about and all the things which you faced during your trip. Thirdly, write an appropriate trip report and submit it to your boss obviously and to all the others, circulate it amongst all the others so that they can learn from that in their next business trip. Okay, follow through on whatever promises you have made. You would have cracked a business deal there. You would have thought about cracking a business deal after going to your country. Whatever you have committed there, follow through and act according to those things. Last but not the least, I already told you this very first, we are Stingy Indians and the Badis. Make sure that you file your expense report with each and every expense return well inside it. And make sure that you reimburse your expenses well from your organization. Do not forget this. How can you? Okay, that's it from my side. Thank you so much for listening to me. Keep traveling. Until next time, this is Ruibat signing off. Bye-bye.